Greetings to you all. I welcome you all to the second part of lesson 11, biodiversity and its conservation. Now hotspot. What are hotspots? Hotspots are areas characterized with high concentration of endemic species experiencing unusual rapid rate of habitat modification loss. Norman Myers defined hotspot as the region that harbors a great diversity of endemic species and at the same time have been significantly impacted on, altered by human activities. A hotspot is a region that supports at least 1,500 endemic vascular plant species, has lost more than 70% of its original vegetation. There are 35 biodiversity hotspots in the world. India is a home for four biodiversity hotspots. They are Himalaya, Western Ghats, Indo-Burma, and entire northeastern India, except Assam and Andaman group of islands. Sundarlands include Nicobar group of islands. Endangered organisms. What are endangered organisms? A species that has been categorized as very likely to become extinct is an endangered species. They are at the edge of extinction. Endangered as categorized by International Union for Conservation of Nature, Red List is the second most severe conservation status for wild population in IUCN scheme after critically endangered. In 1998, there were 1,102 animals and 1,197 plant species in the IUCN Red List. In 2012, the list features 3,079 animal and 2,655 plant species as endangered worldwide. One more species goes extinct. George the tree snail, Acatinella apex fulva, died on January 1st, 2019, at the age of 14. He was the last snail of his species and is emblematic of the loss of native Hawaiian mollusk. Extinction. What is extinction? Species considered extinct when one of its member are alive anywhere in the world. None of its members are alive anywhere in the world. If the individual of a species remain alive only in captivity or other human control condition, the species is said to be extinct in the world. In both of these situations, the species would be considered globally extinct. A species is considered to be locally extinct when it is no longer found in an area once inhabited but still found elsewhere in the world. In the 450 million years of Earth, there had been 5 mass extinctions which had eliminated at least 50% of species of flora and fauna on the globe. The extinction of species is mainly due to drastic environmental changes and population characteristics. Types of extinction. There are 3 types of extinction. One is natural extinction, then mass extinction, then anthropogenic extinctions. Natural extinction. It is a slow process of replacement of existing species with better adapted species due to change in environmental condition, evolutionary changes, predators, diseases. A small population get extinct sooner than the large population due to inbreeding depressions. Mass extinction, the second type. The Earth has experienced quite a few mass extinction due to environmental catastrophes. A mass extinction occurred about 225 million years ago during the Permian, where 90% of shallow water marine invertebrate disappeared. Third one, anthropogenic extinction. These are abated by human activities like hunting, habitat destruction, over-exploitation, urbanization, industrialization. Some examples of extinctions are dodo of Mauritius and Steller's sea cow of Russia. Amphibians seem to be at high risk of extinction because of habitat extinction destruction. The most serious aspect of loss of biodiversity is the extinction of species. The unique information contained in its genetic material and the niche it possesses are lost forever. Project Tiger. The Government of India launched Project Tiger in 1973 to protect our national animal tiger from the Nine Tiger Reserve. Since its inception, the Project Tiger coverage has increased to 50% at present. The Project Tiger is an ongoing centrally sponsored scheme of the Ministry of Environment and Forest, providing central assistance to the states for higher conservation in designated tiger reserves. The Project Tiger was launched in Jim Corbett National Park, Uttarakhand, in 1973. The project ensures viable population of Bengal tigers in their natural habitats, protecting from extinction and preserving areas of biological importance as a natural heritage. The National Tiger Conservation Authority is statutory body of the ministry, created under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. India holds over half the world's tiger population. According to the latest tiger census report released on 20th January 2015 by NTCA, the current tiger population is estimated at 2,212. There are 50 tiger reserves in the country. IUCN. IUCN is the International Union for Conservation of Nature. IUCN's role: conservation of nature and sustainable use of natural resources. It was established in 1948 and located at Glanville, Switzerland. It is involved in data gathering, analysis, research, field projects, education on conservation, sustainable development, and biodiversity. Its mission is to influence, encourage, assist societies throughout the world to conserve nature, to ensure that any use of natural resources is equitable, ecologically sustainable. It influences governments and industries through partnership by providing information and advice. The organization collects, compiles, and publishes the IUCN Red List of threatened species and their conservation status in the world. It plays a vital role in the implementation of several international conservation on nature, conservation and biodiversity. Red Data Book. Red Data Book or Red List is a catalogue of taxa facing risk of extinction. IUCN, IUCN, a natural resource, renamed WCU, that is World Conservation Union, Morges, Switzerland, maintains the Red Data Book. The concept of Red List was mooted in 1963. The purpose of preparation of Red List are to create awareness on the degree of threat to biodiversity, identification and documentation of species at high risk of extinction, provide global index on declining biodiversity, preparing conservation priorities and help in conservation of action, information on international agreement on conservation of biological diversity. Red List has 8 categories of species: extinct, extinct in wild, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, lower risk, data deficiency, not evaluated, etc. Biodiversity and its conservation, principle of Stockholm Declaration in 1972. The natural resource of the earth, including air, water, land, flora and fauna of natural ecosystem, must be safeguarded for the benefit of the present and future generation through careful planning and management. The large-scale loss of biodiversity and its global impact makes conservation the need of the hour. Conservation of biodiversity is protection and scientific management of biodiversity. To maintain it at its optimum level and derive sustainable benefits for the present as well as future generations, it aims to protect species from extinction and their habitats and ecosystem from degradation. General strategies in conservation: identify and protect all the threatened species. Identify and conserve in protected areas the wild relatives of all economically important organisms. Identify and protect critical habitat for feeding, breeding, nursing, resting of each species. Resting, feeding and breeding places of organisms should be identified and protected. Air, water and soil should be conserved on priority basis. Wildlife Protection Act should be implemented. General strategies in conservation: there are 2 aspects of conservation strategies, in-situ conservation, ex-situ conservation. In-situ conservation: this is the conservation of genetic resources through their protection within a natural or man-made ecosystem in which they occur. Its conservation and protection of whole ecosystem and its biodiversity at all level is in order to protect the threatened species. Maximum protection of biodiversity hotspots region with very high level of species richness. Although all the biodiversity hotspots together cover less than 2% of the earth land area, the number of species they harbor is extremely high, and protection of these hot spots could reduce the ongoing masses. Protected area: these are the biogeographical areas where biological diversity along with natural and cultural resource is protected, maintained and managed through legal measures. Protected areas include national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, community reserves, biosphere reserves. World Conservation Monitoring Center has recognized 37,000 protected areas wildlife worldwide. India has about 771 protected areas covering 1,62,99 km of comprising of National Park 104, Wildlife Sanctuary 544, Biosphere Reserves 18, several sacred groves. National Parks. It is the natural habitat that is notified by the state government to be constituted as National Park. Due to its ecological, faunal and floral geomorphological or zoological association of importance. No human activity is permitted inside the National Park except the activities permitted by the chief. While wildlife warden of the state under the condition given in Chapter 4 of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Tabular column shows the national parks in Tamil Nadu and their establishment and where they are located. Gindi National Park, Gulf of Mannar Marine National Park, Indira Gandhi National Park, Mudumalai National Park, Mukurthi National Park. National Parks. There are 104 existing national parks in India, covering an area of 40,501 km², which is 1.23% of the geographical area of country. National park is an area which is strictly reserved for the betterment of wildlife and biodiversity. The following activities like development, forestry, poaching, hunting, grazing, cultivation are not permitted in the national park. There are large areas of scenic and national beauty maintained for scientific, educational and recreational use. They are not used for commercial extraction of resources. Kaziranga National Park is a protected area for the one-horned rhinoceros in Assam. Wildlife sanctuaries. Any area other than area comprised with any reserve forest or territorial waters can be notified by the state government to constitute as a sanctuary if such area is of adequate ecological, faunal, floral, geomorphological, natural or zoological significance. This is for the purpose of protecting endangered factual species. Some restricted human activities are allowed inside the sanctuary area, details of which are given in Chapter 4 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Ecotourism is permitted as long as animal life is undisturbed. There are 544 existing wildlife sanctuaries in India, covering an area of 1,18,918 km², which is 3.62% of geographical area of the country. Sanctuaries are tracts of land where wild animals and fauna can take refuge without being hunted or poached. Other activities like collection of forest product, regulated harvesting of timber, private ownership of land are permitted. Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary in Kerala is famous for Indian tiger and Asiatic elephant. Wildlife sanctuaries in Tamil Nadu. Vedandangal, lake birds and where they are located. Districts: Mudumalai, Nilgiris, Point Kalimar, Nagapattinam, Indira Gandhi, Coimbatore, Mundandurai Wildlife Sanctuary in Tirunelveli. Next one is Biosphere Reserve. Biosphere Reserve is an international designation by UNESCO for representative part of natural and cultural landscape extending over large area of terrestrial or coastal marine ecosystem or a combination thereof. Biosphere reserve are designated to deal with conservation of biodiversity, economic and social development and maintenance of associated cultural values. Biosphere reserves are thus special environments for both people and nature. Biosphere reserves are living example of how human beings and nature can coexist while respecting each other's needs. The Biosphere Reserve Program is guided by UNESCO's Man and Biosphere Program. As India is a single signatory to the landscape approach supported by MAP program, the scheme called Biosphere Reserve was implemented by the Government of India in 1986. There are 18 biosphere reserves in the country. Agastya Malai, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. Nilgiris, Tamil Nadu, Kerala. Gulf of Mannar, Tamil Nadu are the biosphere reserves notified in Tamil Nadu. Sacred groves. Sacred groves or sacred woods are any groove of trees that are of special religious importance to a particular culture. Sacred grove features in various cultures throughout the world. Exit to conservation. It is the conservation of selected rare plants and animals in place outside their natural homes. It includes off-site collection and gene banks. Off-site collections. There are live collections of wild animals and domesticated species in botanical garden, zoological parks, wildlife safari parks, arboreta. The organisms are well maintained for captive breeding programs. As a result, many animals which have become extinct in the world continue to be maintained in zoological parks. As the number increases in captive breeding, the individuals are selectively released in the wild. In this way, Indian crocodile and Gangetic dolphins have been saved from extinction. Gene banks. Gene banks are type of biorepository which preserve genetic material. Seeds of different genetic strains of commercially important plants can be stored in long period in seed banks. Gametes of threatened species can be preserved in viable and fertile conditions for long periods using cryopreservation technique. However, it is not economically feasible to conserve our biological wealth and all ecosystems. The number of species required to be saved from extinction far exceeds the conservation of efforts. Difference between in-situ and ex-situ conservation. It is the on-site, in-situ conservation. It is an on-site conservation or the conservation of genetic resources in natural population of plant or animal species. Ex-situ is the conservation strategy which involves placing of threatened animals and plants in special care locations for their protection. It is the process of protecting an endangered plant or animal species in its natural habitat, either by protecting or restoring the habitat itself, or by defending the species from predators. It helps in recovering populations or preventing their extinction under stimulated condition that closely resemble their natural habitat. The example for in-situ conservation: national parks, biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries form in-situ conservation strategies. Zoological park, botanical garden are common ex-situ conservation programs.
the Madras Crocodile Bank Trust. The Madras Crocodile Bank Trust and Center for Herpetology was the brainchild of the legendary Romulus Whitaker and a handful of like-minded conservation missionaries who began work on the facility in 1976. It aimed to save India's dwindling crocodilian population. The mission is to promote the conservation of reptiles and amphibians and their habitat through education, scientific research and captured breeding. The Crocodile Bank remains a world leader in the field of frontline conservation and preservation of natural landscapes. Crocodile Bank currently consists of a large reptile park near Chennai and several field projects located throughout the subcontinent reaching as far as the Nicobar Islands. About 500,000 people visit Bank every year, making it one of the most popular tourist attractions along East Coast Road. Arinyar Anna Zoological Park, Vandalur. Arinyar Anna Zoological Park is spread over an area of 602 hectares of reserve forest at Vandalur, Chennai. It is one of the largest zoo in Southeast Asia in terms of area. The zoological park exhibits different classes of animals. It has around 2,500 wild animals of nearly 180 species, which include mammals, birds and reptiles. 34 years since its establishment, the zoological park has emerged as successful ex-situ conservation center and a captive breeding center for many endangered species like Royal Bengal tiger, lion tail macaque, Nilgiri langur, grey wolf, etc. Zoo has many attractive features like butterfly park, children's park, walk-through aviary, lion and deer safari, forest museum, interpretation center, etc., which attracts more than 21 lakh visitors every year. The zoo has strengthened its protection by means of installing CCTV cameras for both visitors and animal management under the name of ZooEI. 24/7 animal live streaming was introduced for the benefit of the visitors for the first time in the world. Vandalur Zoo mobile application was introduced to provide services to visitors like facility to book tickets, zoo navigation, animal information in text and audio format, digital payment at ticket counters are also available. The school has been involved in education and outreach program. One such successful program is Zoo Ambassador, which has been conducted for school children. In the year 2018, more than 400 students were trained and titled as Zoo Ambassadors. The zoo also has a rescue center which accommodates rescued wild animals and treat them to come out of stress. So the digital director, Arinyar Anna Zoological Park, Vandalur, Chennai. That's all. Thank you.